Good morning, students. Welcome to the online class. Today, I want to remind you of the structures and uses of tenses. It is very essential to know this chapter of grammar to write and speak English correctly and meaningfully. The word tense is derived from Latin word tempus, which means time. A verb indicates the time of an action, event, or condition by changing its form. Now, the kinds of tenses based on time frame. The verb tenses may be categorized according to the time frame: present tense, past tense, and future tense. Present tense. Present tense expresses an unchanging, repeated, or reoccurring action or situation that exists only now. It can also represent a widespread truth or universal truth. Past tense. Past tense expresses an action or situation that was started and finished in the past. Future tense. Future tense expresses an action or situation that will occur in the future. Now, subkinds of tenses based on aspect. Verb tenses may also be categorized according to aspect. Aspect refers to the nature of the action described by the verb. There are four aspects of tenses: indefinite or simple, continuous or progressive, perfect or complete, and perfect continuous. Indefinite tense. The three indefinite tenses or simple tenses describe an action but do not state whether the action is finished. Continuous or progressive tense. The three continuous tenses or progressive tenses describe an unfinished action. Perfect tense. The three complete tenses or perfect tenses describe a finished action. Perfect continuous tense is used to combine the complete tenses and the incomplete tenses to describe an action which was in progress and then finished. There are 12 possible verb tenses. Verb tenses: present, past, and future. Present indefinite, present continuous, present perfect continuous, now past. Past indefinite, past continuous, past perfect continuous. Future tense. Future indefinite, future continuous, future perfect continuous. Let us take up present tense. Present has four subkinds: present indefinite tense, present continuous tense, present perfect tense, present perfect continuous tense. Now, I will tell you the structure and use of present indefinite tense. The structure is subject plus V1. It may be subject plus V1 plus object also, if the verb is a transitive verb. The simple present is used to describe an action, an event, or condition that is occurring in the present at the moment of speaking or writing. The subject in third person singular number, that is, he, she, it, and their nouns take a verb with S or ES. For example, I play, but he, she, it plays. Now the second subkind of present tense, present continuous tense. The structure is subject plus M is R plus B4 that is be1 with ing plus object. The present continuous emphasizes the continuing nature of an act, event or condition. It shows the incompletion of an action. For example, I am playing, he or she is playing, they are playing. Now, present perfect tense. The structure is subject plus have or has plus be3 plus object, if there is any. The present perfect tense is used to describe action that began in the past and continues into the present or has just been completed. For example, I have played, he or she has played. Now, present perfect continuous tense. The structure is subject plus have or has plus been plus be4 or be1 with ing. The present perfect continuous is used to describe an action, event or condition that has begun in the past and continues into the present. For example, I or you have been playing, he or she has been playing. Now, let us know past tense. It has 4 subkinds: past indefinite tense, past continuous tense, past perfect tense, past perfect continuous tense. Let us know the structure and use of past indefinite tense. The structure is subject plus be2. The simple past tense is used to describe an action, an event or condition that occurred in the past. For example, I played, he or she played. Now, past continuous tense. The structure is subject plus was or were plus be4 or even with ing. The past continuous tense is used to describe actions ongoing in the past. For example, I was playing, he or she was playing, you were playing. Now, let us know past perfect continuous tense. The structure is subject plus had plus been plus be4 or given with ing. The past perfect continuous is used to indicate that a continuing action in the past began before another past action began or interrupted the first action. For example, I had been playing, he or she had been playing. Now, past perfect tense. The structure is subject plus had plus be3. This tense is used only when 2 past actions are concerned. The first action is expressed in past perfect and the second action in simple past tense. Example, I had reached school before the bell rang. Here the first action is reaching school and the following action or the second action is the ringing of the bell. Second example, I had washed my hands before I took my food. Now, future tense. Future indefinite tense, future continuous tense, future perfect tense, and future perfect continuous tense. Future indefinite tense. The structure is subject plus shall or will plus be1. The simple future tense is used to refer to actions that will take place after the act of speaking or writing. For example, I shall play, he or she will play. Future continuous tense. The structure is subject plus shall or will plus be plus be4 or be1 with ing. The future continuous tense is used to describe actions ongoing in the future. The future progressive is used to refer to continuing actions that will occur in the future. For example, I shall be playing, he or she will be playing. Now, future perfect tense. The structure is subject plus shall or will plus have plus V3. The future perfect tense is used to refer to an action that will be completed sometime in the future before another action takes place. For example, I shall have played. He or she will have played. Now, future perfect continuous tense. The structure is subject plus shall or will plus have plus been plus before or given with ing. The future perfect continuous tense is used to indicate a continuing action that will be completed at some specified time in the future. For example, I shall have been playing. He or she will have been playing. Now, here is a list of examples of these tenses. You must go through it attentively.